As usual, I went to cut my daily quota of cedars. When I found a body in a grove in a hollow in the mountains,
first the exact location.
It is about 150 meters from Yamashita Road. Just out of the way of saddles.
The body was lying flat on its back, dressed in a bluish silk kimono. A single sword stroke had pierced the breast.
No blood was nowhere run. I found the wound.
Did you saw any sword or such a thing?
No, nothing. I've only found a rope at the root of the cedar. In addition to that, I found a gold. That's all. Apparently, he must make a battle of it before he was murdered. Because the grass has trampled all around.
Is there a horse nearby?
No, ma'am. It's hard enough for a man to let go of a horse.
According to the Buddhist, it was noon yesterday when he saw the unfortunate man on the road from Sekiyama to Yamashina. He was walking toward the Sekiyama with a woman accompanying him, whom the Buddhist knew to be his wife. Also, according to the Buddhist, that the wife was red-colored suit and her height was about 4 feet and 5 inches. Who is the man you arrested?
The man that I arrested arrested? He's in a tourist rig at Cabote, Jamiro. When I arrested him, he had fallen off the horse. He was moving at the bridge at Atawabuchi.
What is the time?
The time? It was in the early hours of last night. For the record, I might say that the other day I tried to arrest him, but unfortunately escaped. He was wearing a black kimono.
And as you see, he had a bow and arrows somewhere.
Does this bow and arrows look like the ones owned by the Bittermans?
You say that this bow and arrows look like the one owned by the Bittermans? Then the murderer must be the Jamiro. The bow wound with leather strips, the black lacquered quiver, the 17 arrows with hawk feathers. A little beyond the bridge, I found the horse grazing in the roadside with his long mane dangling. Surely there is a providence that peace has been thrown by the horse.
To the murdered man, Takehiko.
The corpse is the man who married Mika. He does not come from Kyoto. He was a samurai in the town of Kokuku in the province of Okasa. His name was Kanazawa no Takehiko, and he was 26 years old.
Then, can you tell me something about your daughter, Masago?
Masago? She is 19 years old. She is a spirited, fun, loving girl. And I'm sure she has never known any man except Takehiko. She has a small, oval, dark-complected face with a mole in the left corner of her eye.
When was the last time that you saw the murdered man, Takehiko?
Yesterday. Takehiko left her casa with my daughter.
Do you have any knowledge on where we could find your daughter, Masado?
What bad luck it is that things should have come to such a sad end. I am resigned of giving up my son-in-law, but the fate of my daughter worries me sick. For heaven's sake, leave no stone unturned to find her. I hate that Robert Ajumar or whatever his name was. Not only my son-in-law, but my daughter.
I made up my mind to capture her and do my best not to kill him, but it's out of the question on the Yamashina stage road. So I managed to lure the couple in the mountains. I told them there was an old mound in the mountain over there and that I had to dig it open and found many mirrors and swords. I went on to tell them I'd buried the things in a grove behind the mountain. Then, you see, Isn't greed terrible? He was beginning to be moved by my talk before he knew. In less than half an hour, they were driving their horse towards the mountain with me. When he came to the front of the grove, I told him that the treasures were buried in it, and I asked him to come and see. The man had no objection. He was blinded by greed. The woman said he would wait on the horseback. It was natural for her to say so. At the sight of the take grove, to tell you the truth, my plan worked just as I wish. So I went to the grove with him, leaving her behind alone. The grove is only bamboo for some distance. About 50 yards ahead, there's rather open clump of cedars. Pushing my way through the grove, I told him a plausible lie that the treasure were buried under the cedars. When I told him this, he pushed his laborious way toward the slender cedar. As soon as we got there, I seized him. Because he was trained, sword-bearing warrior. He was quite strong, but he was taken by surprise. So there was no help for him. I tied him to the root of the cedar. Where did I get rope? Thank heaven, being a robber, I had a rope with me, since I might have to scale a wall at any moment. When I disposed of him, I went to his woman and asked her to come and see him, because he seemed to have very suddenly taken sick. The woman, her sage hat off, came into the depth of the grove, where I led her by hand. The instant she caught sight of her husband, she drew a small sword. I've never seen a woman of such violent temper. No wish to kill him. I was about to run away from the group, leaving the woman behind in tears. When she frantically clung to my arm in broken fragments of words, she asked that either her husband or I die. She said it was more trying than death to have her shame known to two men. She gasped out that she wanted to be the wife of whichever survived. Then the furious desire to kill him seized me. But I didn't like this. And I hid him and told him to cross through to me. Furious with anger, he drew his thick sword and quick as thought. He sprang at me furiously without speaking a word. I didn't tell you how our fight turned out. Nobody under the sun has ever clashed swords with me. That's all my confession. I know my hand will be kind of cheating, so put me down in maximum penalty.
Nasago. any reason why Tajamaru killed your husband?
That man in a black silk kimono, after forcing me to yield to him, laughed mockingly as he looked at my bound husband. How horrified my husband must have been. But no matter how hard he struggled, the rope cut into him more tightly. In spite of myself, I ran stumblingly toward his side. Or rather, I tried to run toward him, but the man instantly knocked me down. Just at that moment, I saw an indescribable light in my husband's eyes. Something beyond expression.
That instantaneous look of his eyes, he couldn't speak a word, told me all his heart.
Then what else happened when you woke up?
In the course of the time, I came to and found the man in black silk was gone. I saw my husband still bound to the root of the cedar. I raised myself and looked into his face, but the expression was just the same as before.
Beneath the cold contempt in his eyes, there was hatred, shame, grief, and anger. I don't know how to express my heart at that time. Reeling to my feet, I went up to my husband.
Since things have come to this pass, I cannot live with you. I'm determined to die, but you must die too. You saw my shame. I can't leave you alive as you are.
This was all I could say. My heart is breaking. I look for his sword, but fortunately, my small sword was lying at my feet. Raising it overhead, once more, I said,
"Now give me your life. I'll follow you right away." When he heard these words, he moved his lips difficultly. But at a glance, I understood his words. Despising me, said, "Kill me." I stabbed a small sword into his kimono, through his breast. I tried to kill myself in many ways. I killed my own husband. I was violated by a robber. Whatever can I do? Whatever can I?
Thank you. what did the murdered man say?
After violating my wife, the robber, sitting there, began to speak confronting words to me. Of course I couldn't speak.
My whole body was tied fast to the root of a cedar. But meanwhile, I winked at her many times, as much as to say, "Don't believe the robber." I wanted to convey some such meaning to her, but my wife, sitting dejectedly on the bamboo leaves, was looking hard at her lap. To all appearance, she was listening to his words. I was agonized by jealousy. In the meantime, the robber went on with his clever talk. The robber finally made his bold, brazen proposal. "Once your virtue is sustained, you can get along with your husband. So won't you be my wife instead? It's my love for you that made me violent toward you."
Criminal talk. My wife raised her face as if in a trance. She had never looked beautiful that before. What did my beautiful wife say in an answer to him while I was sitting bound there? I was lost in space, but I have never thought of her answer without burning in anger and jealousy. This is not the whole of her scene. If that were all, I will not be tormented so much in the dark. When she was going out of the grove as if in a dream, her hand and rubbers suddenly turned pale and pointed at me, tied to the root of the cedar, and said,
"Kill him! Kill him!"
Has such a hateful thing come out of a human mouth ever before? Have such cursed words ever struck a human ear, even once? Even once, such a... Quietly folding his arms, he looked at me and said,
"What will do with her? Kill her or save her?"
While I hesitated, she ran into the depths of the grove. The robber instantly snatched at her, but he failed even to grasp at her sleeve. After she ran away, he took up my sword and my bow and arrows. With a single stroke, he cut one of my bonds. I raised my exhausted body from the foot of the cellar. In front of me, there was shining the small sword which my wife had dropped. I took it up and stabbed it on my breast. A bloody lump rose to my mouth, but I didn't feel anything. Only a lonely night lingered on the cedars and mountains. By and by, the light gradually grew fainter, till the cedars and bamboo leaves were lost to view. Lying there, I was enveloped in deep silence. Then someone crept up to me. I tried to see who it was, but darkness had already been gathering around me. Someone, that someone, drew the small sword softly out of my breast. And once and for all, I sank down into the darkness of space.
Thank you.
Thank you.